2017 Lamborghini Aventador S. This car is iconic. This is the trophy of all vehicles. Even a GTR, even a ZR1, a Z06. This vehicle right here, anywhere you go, head snap, next turn, and this is just a vehicle that is amazing. I'm gonna go over this whole vehicle with you, show you the features and benefits that this Lamborghini Aventador S has. Let's take a minute and do a full walk around. Okay, so what makes the Lamborghini Aventador S different from any other Lamborghini? Well, let's start with the front end here. So I have gone to the Lamborghini factory in Bologna, Italy, and I've seen these vehicles constructed. S's have taken a little more care. I do understand the difference. I'm gonna ask the owner. I got Mike, he's the owner of the vehicle. He's right here with me. So Mike, tell me a little bit about why this front end is different than the other Aventador S.
They aerodynamically used a great white shark and a python to make the front end look a little bit more aggressive. It has a natural, flowing, aggressive line to it. Just an absolutely beautiful color. Grigio is stoke, very high metallic. It almost looks like glitter when you get up on it. It's just an amazing, amazing color.
Trying to get the color through the film here and just trying to, you know, make a video to capture its color is a little bit tough. So maybe some photos, some still photos that we'll add onto this video, we'll do some of that. So on the center here, tell me a little bit more about the on this wheel. Makes it totally different from any other Aventador.
Yeah, so the S comes with quite a few differences. The front end's different, obviously completely redone. The rear is completely redone. The wheels that you see are a center hub. That is actually the lug of the wheel. That comes with a tool. You just attach it to it, spins it right off. One lug pulls the wheel off.
Right.
Like a lot of the Aventador S or Aventador, it comes with carbon ceramic brakes standard on the S model.
Okay.
A couple other high points of the S, the biggest is the four-wheel steering. So at low speed, the rear tires turn opposite the fronts. At high speed, they turn with the fronts. Gives an extremely nimble, very tight turn radius for a car that's 80 plus inches wide and 740 horsepower compared to the standard 700.
No, you pick up an extra 40 horsepower in this vehicle. You have all-wheel steering, which is sick. As you said, just trying to make a turn under 45 miles an hour going around a corner. It cuts like a surgical knife. Would that be safe to say?
Yes, it would be. The back that you're taking a shot of now, completely redesigned, a little more aggressive rear balance. It has a much different exhaust. You can look at the tip, looks much different, but the entire exhaust is titanium. It weighs 20% less. It's actually thinner material, which is why it's 20% less, which makes it considerably louder than the previous Lamborghini Aventadors.
This is definitely a lot louder than the Aventador. I have an Aventador 2015. A neighbor of mine has a 2015, lives next door to me. I hear it every day. This one distinguishedly sounds completely different than the other one, than his regular Aventador, standard Aventador. So you get the Aventador S badging. Also, these intakes here, Countach intakes, tell me a little more about that.
Yeah, so one of the things they did is for the iconic look of the cars, they did put the Countach vents back on the tail section of the car instead of just being flush like the rest of the Aventadors. This is a cue out of the SV.
Uh-huh. And I've watched the SV being built in the factory. You're actually, when you go to the factory in Bologna, you are not allowed to bring a camera. You have to lock it up in the lockers they provide for you. So you can't really see how the vehicles are built, but a lot of craftsmanship and detail goes into each one of these vehicles. They're all hand built by teams that have been there for generations. So the exterior is menacing, I must say. The interior, we're gonna jump in there and take a look at the interior here in a second, but anywhere you go, you pull up in this and necks just snap. Everybody recognizes a Lamborghini. But when they see the Aventador S, that's just class, man. That's just, it just totally takes over anything else on the road. All right, so let's take a dive to the inside of the Aventador. So the door handles underneath here and how easy that pops open. The Aventador is lit up with LEDs. I know you can't tell it's daytime right now, but at night this looks absolutely gorgeous. Your carbon fiber door seals, which look just menacing. And of course, the whole bucket of this vehicle, if we could tear it apart, the entire bucket from the dash to the back of the seats, all that is carbon fiber. If you ever have gone through one of these in detail, when we open the door, it does light up and says Lamborghini, of course, there on the dash. We're gonna get a chance to actually go through, do a little start on the vehicle, and show you some features. Mike, tell me some differences on the interior on the S versus the regular Lamborghini. I think we talked about, we'll start with the headliner.
Seats are a little bit more firm. The whole interior is Alcantara. There's no like normal leather in the car. It's tough to catch in a camera, but the whole inside, the roof line, everything's Alcantara. It's all piped in yellow to match the calipers. The stitching on the steering wheel is yellow. The biggest change on the interior, besides the dash cluster changing with the modes, so obviously Street, Sport, Corsa, when you change those modes with the Aventador S, you do change the instrument cluster. It does change the display, but it also has another mode called Ego, which allows you to custom tailor the driving experience to you. So the Street, Sport, and Corsa modes, you can tailor the suspension, the exhaust note, and the steering precision to your liking, and that's called Ego, which in Italian means me.
And also, so you would get all that information based right there in the where it says car setup. So you make those adjustments from there, or where are the adjustments? Oh, I see the...
You see just a button right at the top, right above the start, the red yep. start switch.
So you got Strada, that's Sport, it. Eco, yep, got it. So, incredible. Of course, with every Lamborghini, all the stitching. When I toured the factory in Italy, I got to actually see three generations of ladies that have done the leather, all hand stitch, all done by hand. Every door panel, every dash, every roof insert, everything in this vehicle is just by far one of the most amazing things to see here. So
you know, until you actually fork up the $500,000 it is to buy a car like this, you really don't ever get a drive one. They don't do test drives on these cars. You really don't get a look in them and play with them. So I think the video is important. Even if somebody's not interested in buying the car, just to at least see the fit and finish and quality and refinement in a car like this compared to, say, a very nice Porsche, couple hundred thousand dollars, maybe a Ferrari for a couple hundred thousand that they mark up for $300,000-$400,000. There is no other car that has this fit and finish.
By far none. Looks like we have a CD insert down here, SD1 and SD2. Information that you can get from the vehicle or upload to the audio?
Yeah, they have what's called a jukebox, so you can download your own music to the car so it stays in it even without your phone, or it'll stream your music to the head unit.
So hard drive for that, and then of course streaming as you would find in many new vehicles. So I wanted to show you as I started to do this is the seat. To release the seat, you stick your hand underneath the headrest. There's this handle right here that you depress, and then of course to open the engine bonnet, which we're going to get into that here, that's your release for the engine bonnet, and I'm going to show you that in part three of this, another portion of the video. And just in case you have children like me, I do see the child seat tether anchor in case you want to bring your kids in the Aventador S. It's always good. And you see the lights up right there. 336 miles, automobile Lamborghini, as it says there on the dash. And
that may climb after this video a couple hundred miles every other month.
All right, let's take a look at the engine. Okay. So Lamborghini's iconic V12. It actually says right here, this is your firing order for the cylinders. Cylinder 1, 12, 4, 9, 2, 11, 6, 7, 3, 10, 5, 8 is the firing order on every V12 Lamborghini Aventador. That's how they sequence in the firing. I mean, this car is just when you pop this open here, this is what makes the vehicle so balanced, so just extremely incredible. This is in the third stage, I do believe, in the construction of this vehicle, is when they actually put the engine into the engine and transmission, which is all just combined back here. It is pretty menacing when you see them put this together, but there's 740 horsepower this thing torques out to. What else can you say about this car? Set that right there. That is music to the ears. That is everything firing. That's that exhaust. It just smells good, man. Just smells good when you hear this thing start up. That's the firing power of this V12. What else? One more time, I didn't hear it, Mike. That's actually ear piercing. My left ear actually hurts from that. So, this is the power plant that makes it all happen. This is what makes this so different from any other vehicle. The engine does sit forward and backwards like it would if it was up front in a typical rear-wheel drive vehicle, not left and right, but fore and aft, longitudinally, as they refer to it as. And I absolutely just love this car, man. So we're gonna take this actually in another portion of the video. All right, for the last portion of the vehicle, if you decide to take a little road trip, you gotta be able to bring something to take with you. So a little overnight bag. So this is where we store all those goodies at, right in the front. So it better be something, a small duffel bag. Yeah, you can get some stuff in there.
It does have a little bit more storage space. We just bought an 18 Roadster, which is why this one's up for sale. So the 18 Roadster, this is where you would store the top for the car. It's in two pieces. It stores in here. It also has your owner's kit with tools and roadside assistance, that kind of stuff. It's never been opened. Comes with your white Lamborghini gloves, and you'll see the tool down at the very bottom behind it. It's wrapped in white. That's the tool for the Velcros to the back. Mm-hmm. But the tool for the wheel.
Tool for the wheel.
Which is right there.
And it is heavy.
Yeah, it is.
And that's what fits the wheel, so you can actually, if the wheel would ever need to be removed for maintenance or for anything else.
Yeah, the cool thing about Lamborghini, though, if you buy it new or pre-owned, it has the roadside attached to the car. It's a 3-year, 36,000, unlimited mileage warranty. But if you ever have an issue, if you ever need it serviced, all you do is pick up the phone, call Lamborghini. They'll come and actually put the car in a enclosed carrier, bring it to the dealership, do the service, wash it, wax it, fill it with gas, and then return it to you. So it's not like they hook it with a rope and then start to yank it to the dealership.
I've seen that. Actually, Lamborghini in Sarasota here actually has a enclosed car carrier. They come pick up the vehicle, take it in for service, wash it, bring it back to you. Offer a minimal fee, but hey, it's part of the experience. It's part of having the most iconic vehicle ever built on the road, a Lamborghini Aventador S, and this could be yours, available for sale. Look in the below in the comments, and you'll see how you can actually get in contact with us and purchase this vehicle. Thanks for watching.